working as assistant professor in a civil engineering department of Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In the last lecture, we have seen what is a gradually varied flow and a dynamic equation for the gradually varied flow. Depending on that, in this session, we are going to solve some problems. So, at the end of this session, you are able to find the most important thing, that is a slope and the length of the channel, which may be on the upstream or which may be on the downstream, by using gradually varied flow equation and the step method. The first example, a rectangular channel of width 10 meter and normal depth of flow is 1.75 meter, has a bed slope 1 in 1600, obstruction in the form of overflow dam at the section rises the level of water by 1 meter. Calculate the slope of water surface with respect to horizontal line. Assume the Manning's coefficient as 0.025. Read the problem once again. Basically, we must know what is a fill depth, what is a critical depth, and what is a normal depth. Depending on these depth, three depths, we are finding out which type of slope it is. If yn is greater than yc, yn, or we can say y0 also, greater than yc, that means normal depth is greater than critical depth. It is a mild slope. When yn is, or y0 is equal to yc, normal depth is equal to critical depth, it is a critical slope. When critical depth yc is greater than y0 or yn, it is a this is a steep slope. Then the fourth one is horizontal slope, where the y is imaginary, and adverse, where y we cannot find out. Here, depending on these slopes and three zones, 15 water surface profiles are expected. But as you know, C2 or critical slope 2 is not possible because yn and yc are coinciding. And in horizontal and adverse, zone 1 is imaginary. That's why these h1 and a1 are not possible. So, 5 slopes and 3 zones, we are expecting 15, but C2, H1 and A2 are not possible. We are having only 12 water surface profiles. Now concentrate on this. First of all, find out discharge. Discharge is area into velocity. Here, velocity we have to find out with the formula of Manning's, because Manning's coefficient is given to us, that is 0.025. For Manning's formula, that is 1 upon n, r raised to 2/3 and s raised to 1/2. Here r is hydraulic mean depth or hydraulic mean radius. This is nothing but area upon weighted perimeter. Here area is 10 into 1.75 meter upon perimeter. This is a 1.75 on one side, on the other side 1.75, and the horizontal is 10. So we will get 17.5 upon 13.5 as R. This is 17.5 upon 13.5 as R. By calculating, by substituting this value, we will get discharge as 20.81 meter cube per second. Small q, it is a discharge per meter width. So q upon b, width is 10, it is 20.81 upon 10, it is 2.081 meter cube per second per meter. We cannot say it is meter square per second, it is meter cube per second per meter always. Critical depth, we know, that is from the Froude's number we have calculated it. Yc is equal to cube root of q square upon g. This is the small q, that already the value we have calculated. Put this value, we will get YC is equal to 0.76 meters. Y0, which is a normal depth given in the problem, 1.75 meter. So 1.75 meter, and by obstruction the water level is rises by 1 meter, which is given in the problem. Obstruction in terms of a small weir, the water level rises by 1 meter. So 1.75 plus 1, this is the field width, that is 2.75 meter. Now see, 2.75 is y, y0 is 1.75 and yc is 0.76 meter. This is a mild slope because normal depth is greater than the critical depth, and y is greater than these two values, so that y is greater than y0, which is greater than yc. I can say this is a M1 type of water surface profile. Now by using the equation of gradual varied flow with respect to Manning's formula, dy by dx is equal to h0m into bracket 1 minus y0 upon y bracket raised to 10 by 3 upon 1 minus yc upon y bracket q. Put these values, we get 5.031 into 10 to the power minus 4. But the answer is asked, the slope with respect to horizontal. So slope with respect to horizontal is nothing but s0 minus dy by dx. s0 is 1 upon 1600, and dy by dx, we have calculated it. So the answer for this, it is 1 upon 12190. Here we have calculated only dy by dx. Here we have used the equation of gradual varied flow, where Manning's formula is inserted so that the equation becomes equation representing with the depths. So my question, sir, you have to write the Manning's and Chadha's formulae. And what's the criteria for mild surface profile? Chadha's and Manning's formula are for measurement of velocity. That is, for Manning's it is V is equal to 1 upon N, R is to 2/3 and S is to 1/2, where N is Manning's coefficient, R is hydraulic mean depth, and S is a slope. Chadha's formula is V is equal to C under root RS, C is Chadha's constant, R is hydraulic mean depth, and S is a slope. And our question number 2, the answer is, normal depth of flow is more than critical depth, then it is a mild surface profile. A very wide rectangular channel carries a discharge of 3132 liters per second per meter width at a depth of 2 meter. A weir constructed across this channel raises the water level by 2 meter just upstream of it. Locate the point upstream of the weir at which the depth of water will be 3 meters. Assume bed slope of the channel as 1 in 4900. Assume value of C, here Chadha's formula is used, as 50. Use step method, and they asked us to go for two steps. Here small q is directly given to us, that is 3132 liters per second per meter, but it is in liter, we are converting it into meter cube. Divide this equation by 1000, q is equal to 3.132 meter cube per second per meter. Y0 is given to us 2 meter, and now as we know yc, that is calculated from the Froude's number, yc is equal to cube root of q square upon g, we will get yc as 1 meter. Now depth of water just upstream of it, it is rises by 2 meter, y0 plus 2, it is 4 meter, that is y. So y is 4 meter, y0 is 2 meter, and yc is 1 meter. So y is greater than y0, which is greater than 1. I told you previous also, in the previous example also, the same situation was there. 4 is greater than 2 is greater than 1, which is a M1 type of profile and mild slope. Now, what is the specific energy? Specific energy is nothing but the y, or the, you can say, the p by w, or pressure head plus velocity head. Here we are not going to take the static head or datum head, we are not going to take. Specific energy is nothing but it is a addition of p by w, that is y, and kinetic head v square upon 2g, we can say. Put these values, find out s1, similarly find out s2. Here s2 is y2 plus v2 square upon 2g. Similarly, find out ES3. So ES1, ES2, ES3 we have calculated as 4.03, 3.54 and 3.055 meters. For a very wide rectangular channel, already we have defined the R, hydraulic mean depth, is taken as Y. So in the Manning's formula, wherever there is a R, we have to keep Y. That is for wide rectangular channel, not for any other channel. Otherwise, we have to calculate separately A by P. Put these values, we will get SF, which is 6.13. Similarly, SF2. Similarly, SF3. Then we have to find out the averages of these two, SF1-2, SF2-3. Put these values. Delta L1 is nothing but ES2 minus ES1 upon S0 minus SF mean. SF mean of 1-2 first and then 2-3 second. In the 1-2, we are getting 3840 and the second we are getting 5260. Take an addition of these two, it is 9.1 kilometers. This is the perfect procedure for solving by step method, or we can say direct step method. We can solve this by single step also. In the next problem, we will compare this method with a single step directly and we'll compare the results. These are some reference books for you. Thank you.